Right, part two, Commodore 64, number two. One thing I didn't get very well in the first video was this thing. Didn't really show it very closely. I don't know what that is. Anybody know what that is? It's like pinched at one end. Anyway. Right, working but can't take port issues. This is a case in slightly better condition. Still a bit yellowed on top. All the keys are there though. And nothing wrong on that side. Doesn't look like there's too much corrosion in the edge connectors. Let's get it open. I noticed in the first one I was pulling all sorts of weird places, so I'll try not to do that so much. Sorry for any offence I caused with my face. Ooh. What? Getting a bit of deja vu here. What's going on here? They are exactly the same. How bizarre. It's got that same short capacitor there. SID is soldered as well. Was that soldered on the last one? I don't remember. How bizarre. So this one, like he says, works, but has cart tape and port issues. There's a little bit of wear on those fingers, but it doesn't look like they're going to make bad contact. So I think the first thing to do is to plug it in. So, light, good. Let's go with diagnostics. CIA's accounting up normally so far. Okay, that all looks fine. Let's get the diagnostic harness on it. I don't think I'm going to put the... can I fit it on there? Where is one? Oh, it's that end. Yeah, so it goes that way around and it doesn't fit on there in the case. It's a bit of a shame. I'll probably just hold that on there. It might make good enough connection. Wonder if this has got a dead CIA. Serial port. So U2, possibly bad. Yeah, interesting. Right, this is interesting as well. I've got, this is the Commodore 64 from the last video. And you see, it's identical. So it's a 250407, artwork 251137, version C, and the chip dates are all so similar. 4383 on the SID, 4383 on that SID. They're exactly the same, but this one's 6581 CBM and this one's just this 6581. 2983, 4283, these within a couple of weeks. It's so weird. These must have been really close on the production line. That's bizarre. But this one's had an easier life. Really weird. I wonder if it was the same person. Ooh, look at that capacitor there. It doesn't look good. I wonder if it was the same person that put these together. That's lovely. But yeah, the same, exactly the same sockets. Right, back to this one. So that's... And the CIA still... No, the CIAs are not counting up together. Interesting. So U2 is probably bad. But that looks like an easy fix. That'll be over in a matter of minutes.
Let's save you. I can pull faces as much as I like now.
Good grief. Wow. Case clips like. It's the outside ones are still there. Not going to worry too much about that. Screws. So we are U2. Bad. That's it. Right, thank you very much for watching. I think I might look at some Spectrum. So we can go Amiga or Spectrum. There's three Amigas and there's many Spectrums. Let's have a look at the Amigas next, because there's an A500 Plus that it needs its battery removed. So that'll be a slightly longer video, but it's not going to be the repair. I'm not sure it will be a repair. But yeah, that's what we're going to do next. Amiga A500 Plus. Stay tuned. You can't tune these things.